I decide. One to restrain, and one to kill. Only the best call the shots.
What's up, guys? We're back with another Operator Mastery here with Zofia, as requested by one of you guys. So Zofia is just kind of the second coming of Ash, and is just an entry fragger just like Ash. So we're going to go over everything from top to bottom here with Zofia, starting with best class or best guns to use, best attachments, in my opinion, of course, to use. Then, of course, we get to playstyle and actual in-game tips towards the later end of the video. So if you are new to this series, just let me know what operators you guys want to see down below, and I'll get to them in the next few weeks. I post two of these a week, once every Tuesday, Thursday, and I could do more if you guys want. These just become a little bit tedious if I do more than two a week, but if you guys want more than two, then just let me know. So let's start off with the class loadout. She has two very good guns, very good utility, and a very flexible role. So let's just go into the weapons here. She has two very good weapons as the primary weapons, and she has the pistol as the backup. So the primary weapons, you get the choice of the AR with the M762, which has a good damage at 45 and a high fire rate at 730. It has a 30 round capacity, while the LMGE has a 41 damage, 720 fire rate. So they're pretty similar in that case, but it has 150 rounds and a slower ADS. So that is the two comparisons between the two. And then you have the R615 as your primary secondary weapon, and it has a scope on it, and it's actually a pretty good pistol, so that's always a good, and that's your only choice. So you obviously have to go with that, and then a Claymore as your backup, or a breaching recharge. Obviously a Claymore there, as you are going to want that over a breaching charge, since your utility is literally two breaching charges and two stuns. So my suggested loadout here, I usually go with the M762, but the LMG is definitely a usable gun. It's just the way I play Zofia as an entry fragger, I'm going to want the fastest ADS and the most mobility, and obviously LMGs are worse than ARs when it comes down to utility for mobility, I guess. And then the M762, you can equip the angled grip, which makes the ADS time even more fast than it usually is. Aside from that though, you can always do a vertical grip. It'll still be faster than the LMG when it comes down to it, just because the size of the weapon. And then a flash hider will do pretty well on this weapon, as well as a hollow or an ACOG, whatever you like to rock. ACOG is good and all for increased long range visibility, but if you're playing aggressively, I would recommend a holographic, honestly. But on this operator, depending on how I'm playing it, and I usually plan this out before the round, and if I know where they're gonna go, of course, and can predict that, I will pick where I'm gonna push with Zofia and then switch the scope accordingly. But for the most part, I rock with a holographic on most guns, just to keep a one-to-one consistency with my hip fire. Secondary, you have one choice there, the R615, and then a muzzle brake is obviously good for pistols, or a suppressor if you want to go silent there. And as we've stated, we want to go Claymore over the soft breaching, since your gadget is soft breaching in general. Now that we have our loadout set up, let's go over the gadget, which is a lot like Ash's gadget in the way that you shoot it, but it has two additional benefits with the two concussion grenades that you can also switch between by clicking B or whatever it is on Xbox and PS4. Zofia's charges can do everything Ash's charges, and also get stopped by Jaegers as well, just like a normal Ash charge would. It can destroy maestro cams, castles, soft walls, barbed wire, anything like that. It'll destroy, and you could also go under and get bandit charges, since it will get any soft floors as well. So basically identical to Ash's utility, just a slower operator with, I would say, better weapons. Additionally, you get the two concussion grenades, which should also be useful, but you guys play the same role as a Ash and a Zofia, or you should be. I mean, most Ashes just rush, but you have the same role in general, which is entry fragging, advancing your team up, and trying to get those first easy frags. Another cool thing about Zofia that she has is she's able to withstand. So that means whenever she gets down, she can basically revive herself, but she only gets up with 5 damage, and it takes longer than a teammate revive. So it's pretty situational, but it's still cool to know that that is within her realm. So back to her playstyle as a entry fragger. So you're not going to be wanting to play with support operators like Thermite and Thatcher, operators like that. You're definitely going to want to lead the chase in entry fragging in general. I have a video on entry fragging if you want more in depth, but basically you're just trying to roam clear as much as you can, obviously, and that is how you should be getting your entry frags. And it doesn't mean you have to go from top floor to bottom floor with Zofia. You just have to get control of rooms that are near the site. So maybe above, below, whatever it might be, you of course use your charges. I think a good example is on Consulate. Whenever they are defending garage, you have to get control of piano room and main lobby, and that's a good role for Zofia and your more entry operators like Sledge, Buck, Zofia. Those are good operators to take piano and main lobby. So in short, you gotta be not afraid to take gunfights. You have to at least challenge a few people, because usually there are gonna be people where you're gonna wanna go. And if there's not, you're probably either in the wrong spot or they are a very bad team. It just depends on how the rest of the round goes. There's a lot of examples I can go through literally every map, and it would take a 30-minute video to do that, but that is just not what I'm trying to do with these masteries. I'm trying to go over just a broad concept of Zofia in general, and that would be entry fragging and picking a good entry point for you and your team to advance further into the round and get some easy kills off the rip. So you might be wondering, why not just pick Ashe at that point? Obviously, she has the stuns. That's why Zofia is a little bit better gadget-wise. And I think the only time to pick Ashe really is if you are trying to do a hard push onto objective. Even Zofia might be better at that. Zofia has really, really good guns, might even be better than Ashe's. I don't know. They're both really excellent guns. And they both have the same role where they aren't completely vital to the team's success, so it's not as important as a Thermite or a Thatcher or a Hibana in some cases, just those main support operators. You are less important, and it's okay if you die. Defenders are already at a disadvantage, so you might as well just try to entry frag and, you know, see what happens, see if you can get some kills, and if you get a entry kill, you improve your team's chances by a lot. So basically, Zofia is stupidly easy to get used to, so it's a very good operator and very simple mechanically. It's one of those operators that you can really get into, and you just need basic game sense, basic knowledge on roles, and you'll be able to at least produce some kills with her. Zofia doesn't need a lot of explaining, so this is going to be a shorter video, but I think I have one more thing to say really about Zofia in general, and your main advantage over Ashe, the reason I pick her sometimes over Ashe is usually the ADS speed, because she has the angled grip on her best gun and the ACOG on her best gun. So if those are two things you're looking for and you don't like that the R4C does not have an ACOG or angled grip, then maybe Zofia is the move for you, and that's the only time I would probably switch over from Ashe to Zofia. But if you are a rush, shove it up their throat type of guy, then you might just want to stick with Ashe, but Zofia is definitely worth the shot in general. As a Zofia, you can rip someone off the shield. If they're on a shield, you can plow them off that by hitting them with a breaching charge and then hit them with a stun and then get easy kills. And just learning mechanically how fast it takes to switch from, you know, your gadget to your weapon, ADS, just knowing that things, that's just all basic game sense. If you get the hang of that, you'll be good at Zofia, you'll be good at any operator, but Zofia can be really, really good, and it's really highly used in Pro League even as a entry fragger. Most of the time over Ashe, just because of the added utility, and people just love Zofia in general since she has so much uniqueness to her over a basic operator like Ashe. So that's all I have for you guys. Hopefully this helped. Obviously, it's a pretty newer based mastery this time, since Zofia doesn't need any complex explaining, in my opinion. She is a very basic operator that requires just a little bit of map knowledge and a ability to at least just adapt to situations, be able to push by yourself, which is key, and not always have to rely on your teammates. If you are one of those players that needs to rely on your teammates, this is a good operator to learn and reach out of your comfort zone. But if you still just can't get the hang of it, you know, stick to support operators. Be your Thatcher, be your Thermite, and you'll help your team win without having to frag out. So that's all for you guys. Hopefully you enjoyed. I want to know what other operators you want to see, and next week I already have it planned out. I'm going to do Capkin and Buck, so if you guys want to see anything in specific from them, or you have some like just advanced tips that maybe I don't even know, leave them in the comments for those two operators, and then I'll throw it into the video and help everyone else, which is a win-win for everyone. Plus I'll give you some credit as well, of course. So with that, hopefully you have a fantastic day, and I'll see you in the next video, which I don't know when it'll be. I think it might be the day after the next. I've been doing daily uploads the whole weeks, but I'm sort of running out of ideas. I think I'm gonna go with some new series soon, but until then, I will see you in the next one.